not able to do what we're able to do here. They'll send stuff back, and we make sure we put A&M stickers all over it, so we send it back to them. But what we basically do here is build custom scientific glassware. Obviously, y'all have, well, been to college, you've been seeing all the scientific glassware you see in the labs, and it's pretty standard stuff. What we try to mainly do is do specialized things that can only be bought by custom process. You don't want to send something to New Jersey to have it done that's very unique to a certain experiment. So that's what we do. So we kind of collaborate with the professors. A lot of them, they know what they want it to do, but they may not know how to get the glassware to do it. So we kind of collaborate with them, and sometimes it's a 2 or 3 step process, and we fill the trash cans up. But hopefully by the end, we'll have something that's a usable piece of glassware, and oftentimes they're unique, one-of-a-kind things. We've even been involved in a patent in here. So that's really nice, especially with A&M being as diverse as it is. I mean, we'll be making a glass horse eyeball one week, and we'll be sending something out to the Gulf the next, or maybe something into space. So you never know what you're going to do, and the diversity is what kind of keeps this job challenging. To be able to show y'all what I do, it's kind of hard to show you from start to finish, because anything that's really interesting generally takes about 2 to 3 days. And it's an assembly process where you build all the smaller parts, and then you build those into medium-sized parts, and then you put them into the larger part. And a great example of that would be something like this, which is a mercury diffusion pump. This creates vacuum, and they don't use these much anymore because it uses mercury to pump with. Mostly they've gone to silicone type deals. But you can see a bunch, you can see this is walls inside of walls inside of walls. It's 4 jackets there, the outer jacket, inner jacket, one inside of that, and one inside of that. So you would build, you know, this part, you would build the inside part, the next part, you build this part and all these different pieces, and then you kind of just start putting them together. And the glass we use is mainly Pyrex. We use some quartz, but mainly Pyrex because its expansion coefficient is fairly low. So you can get away with heating it up fairly uniformly and it won't crack. Where, you know, if you stuck a Coke bottle in a campfire, it usually shatters. Well, this won't do it as easy. It will do it, but not as easy. And so we can get away with making these big ring seals and stuff like that. But it's just a process of learning how to do these things, and there's so many variables, because it's not like a machinist where you turn a machine, 3 cranks, and you know it goes X number of thousandths of an inch. This is more of a feel type thing. You have to kind of know how to hold your torch, because if it's blowing this way, it's not going to work. But if it's blowing this way, it'll work, because it's pushing the glass itself. So these are kind of just some examples of what we do. This is kind of a demonstration piece we did for one of our professional societies, and it shows you kind of how we would make a jacketed flask with ports on it. So you can see we would have taken the inside flask, pushed those dents in it, we'd have taken the outside flask, and we'll crack it in half. And you can use what helps you out, what hurts you in cracking, you can use it to help you. You can put a little scratch on this, spin it, and heat it radially, hit it with a little squirt of water, and it'll just crack right around here, and then you pull it in half. So then we would come in here and we would weld the outside flask on, and then we would seal one of these joints on here. You can see what it looked like before we sealed it on there. You would heat that up, sink it down on there, and it touched that little rim and seal, and then you can blow the center out and then bring this joint in and weld it on. And then we would finally come in, bring the bottom of the flask back on, weld it around here, seal it here, and put a drain on it. So I kind of say that's a long process, and y'all would really get bored if I showed you how to build this, but you can kind of see, and you'll see some of the things that I would have done on here when we go over to the bench and work on it.
Is that like an acid machine?
No, those are actually ground together.
Oh,
that's wow. These joints here, and they use a grease you put in between them. When you put them together, they are vacuum tight.
Got it.
So you can hold a good vacuum with those, and it's just a way to make big pieces of glassware are smaller, but you can hook everything together.
How many glass blowers do you have looking
at? You were looking at it. I also have a student worker, Preston, over here. He's been with me for about 1.5 years now, and real value to have good student workers.